I'm not going to be one of these guys that comes on and says fuck all. How can we win this league with a fucking Sabutio goalkeeper? And Sean would run me and jump and just and a table in a pub would just collapse me. And you tell your friend Leon, I fucking kill him if I ever get him. £6,000 a week he's on, lads. I had to come off against Crawley because I shit myself. I wasn't feeling well that day and I fucking farted and felt. I was like, gaffer, I need to come off, I'm done here. Mamma mia, I come from Rome. 12 bedroom house, 6 million in the bank, Bentley to this shithole. So Billy's like, add to me, 500 quid of that and I'll run the last length naked. Cheltenham, we were like, ah, fuck off. Tony Mowbray's team talk after the game was just all about, you little bastard, all you done for 12 minutes was run about asking Modric for his top. You think you're the big man? You're out in Swindon with the music that you like to dance. And mate, you're so scared, but you're also trying not to laugh. And then he went, you like to drink the poison?
So, Ferry.
What's happening, lads? All right?
How you doing? Man.
Thanks for coming on. You know, you're going to know what you need to do.
You know the crack, don't you?
What happens in these things?
Scrap the notes.
I'm fucking ready to go, mate. Can't wait. Let's do it, man. I'm not going to be one of these guys that comes on and says fuck all. I'll go for it. So
that would help us out.
Yeah. That is nothing worth saying.
It's quite annoying. Sometimes it can be tricky, can't it? Oh. People don't realise, do they, how fucking skilled we are.
Oh, mate, it's not as easy as it looks. I know. People see that. Oh, that looks like the easiest job in the world. It's tough, man. Isn't it?
He come on with you yesterday, didn't he?
He was one of the fucking. That's what I'm saying.
Well, you both did. He was like a Cheshire cat. You finally got to tell his stories to two lads that hadn't heard him fucking 300 times before.
He told one story that none of us knew about pissing in the tunnel.
In the tunnel, that was brilliant.
100 shows we've done and we haven't heard that story once.
That's how that was. I got that out. You thought it?
Yeah, that's because you have skills.
Skills.
There you go. Get rid of the one that used to, and I'll fucking join in. Yeah. Who's in charge of use free? Oh, that's
everybody
a
likes
subject,
split.
Isn't it?
Yeah.
Carol Pilkin, isn't it?
Are you pointing at yourself there?
Yeah. Great. I got asked for his autograph last week. Got asked for Carl Pilkin's autograph.
Did you?
Yeah. No way.
In the khaki. I went with it, like.
Did you sign it?
Yeah.
What a dick.
I got it. Should come back at all. Winners of the podcast awards.
That was a while ago, wasn't it?
Hold on a minute. It wasn't.
It's a sensitive subject for him.
It was the flipping auto windscreen shield trophy. It wasn't the main one. It was the one nobody wanted.
The Johnson's paint, mate. That I got to it. The final of that. Never even told my mum and dad that I got to the final. With Johnson's paint, like, it's not something you fucking brag about, is it?
Did you play at Wembley?
Played at Wembley, mate, 3 times.
Yeah, snap. Anybody else?
Any use, nah?
Nah.
Fucking hopeless. But you got beat every time, though.
No, I. Two wins and a loss.
Did you, right?
Yeah. Sorry, can I interrupt that? Do you know, if whatever we're talking about, he always manages to bring it back
on himself.
Whatever subject, that's a skill.
I've got a wee ginger guy on my podcast that does the exact, ginger guy that does the exact same thing, mate. So
yeah,
I know
I
you
prefer
feel.
Doing yours than ours. You know what I mean? I'm just talking about
it. Can we do a swap, Dale?
I want it for a minute. See, on Wembley, though, we played Millwall when they were fucking proper Millwall, mate, in the playoff final. Neil Harris, Tony Craig. That was my first time and we're standing in a tunnel, right? And Neil Harris was looking at me and he's like, look at him. He's fucking shitting himself. And I was like, how the fuck does he know I'm shitting myself?
You were like.
Mate, the 90 minutes absolutely passed us by. Neil Harris, like, I was a sitter for Swindon, so Neil Harris played just off the front for Millwall. He just bashed me a bit for 90 minutes, mate.
It's tiring pitch, like, isn't
it?
No one to say you get tired.
Huge, mate, isn't it?
Yeah.
Did you win?
Nah, I got beat 1-0. Charlie Austin missed a fucking sitter with 10 minutes to go to take it to extra time. Fucked us.
Did you want it to go to extra time, though?
Nah. No. Happy to take the defeat, mate.
Well done, Millwall.
All the best.
And yeah, you deserve that, lad.
Also played there with Celtic, mate, and got Modric to stop, eh?
Yeah?
Got on for like 12 minutes. And we beat Tottenham 1-0 that day, and Tony Mowbray's team talk after the game was just all about, you little bastard, all you done for 12 minutes was run about asking Modric for his top.
At least you got it, though, didn't you?
Exactly.
You
no, I lost it, mate. I got steaming and lost it as well.
What? So you not got it now?
Nah, I lost it, man.
Get him on the podcast, see if we can bring one.
We look at. Get him on, mate. But bad memories of Wembley. Then we got beat 2-0 for Chesterfield in the JPT final. Dog shit final.
I think they beat us in the semi at Fleetwood.
Chester, they're pure specialists in the Johnson's paint,
yeah,
aren't they?
I'm sure they beat us in the Northern final.
But mate, that final was so weird because you know the Johnson's paint, I think the semi final's in November and then you didn't play the final of the summer. So see, Di Canioooo, he's the most superstitious guy ever, right? So in the semi final, mate, you had like 5 layers on. With a tammy and a scarf. So we get to the final, mate, and he walks in the dressing room. It's fucking summer in London. It's like 90 degrees, mate. He walks in, five layers, scarf, tammy on. I couldn't even concentrate on the game, mate. I just looked. I thought he was going to have a fucking stroke on the side of the pitch.
All game.
Absolute dab on, man.
All game.
The whole game, mate, he kept on. And then after the game, he went off his tits saying, I've wore these five layers for you bastards, and he's a fucked
up. We'll get on to him in a bit. I'm not a big fan of him.
Di Canioooo?
No.
We've never met him, have we?
No, do you know what? Like, if you met him, mate, you'd love him, mate.
See, anybody who gets you in for 78 days straight, they're not for me.
But it's funny. Every day's funny, mate.
I can't see it. I'm going to have to disagree with you. I can't see it.
Uh-huh. Funny in what way, though?
Just eventful. Like, there would never be a day you would just go in, mate, and nothing would happen. You would never just go in, train, and come home. Like, there'd be a crisis every day, mate. He'd be going fucking mental about something every single... I used to love him, mate. Honestly, it was brilliant. We'll come to him in a bit, but he's... I think you would eventually like him.
I think after day four in... We had a day off, that's me.
Yeah, it's a day's off.
See, if you can get past the first 2 months with Di Canioooo, it's all right, man.
At first, you do think,
what is this, man? But then, after it, you can kind of see where he's coming from. And it does help. Like, that's the best football I've ever played in my career under him.
Majority of the lads with him, like I said, we'll get onto it there, but...
Do you know the best thing? People come in, I've seen some big names coming at Swindon, because we signed big players on loan, and they were like, nah, I'll not take it for him. I'll say something back to him, and every one of them shit themselves. Yeah. He's so intimidating, mate. He gets in your boat, mate.
That's bad from them. That's fucking shit out from them.
I can imagine you would say something, eh?
Yeah, Paulo.
I'll tell him when I get in the morning. I'll tell him when I go.
Would you?
Hey, Paulo, you're right.
Eating his salad morning. For breakfast. Yeah. Yeah, Paulo. The only one that I've seen answering him back, like, proper go for it, was Leon Clark.
Mm.
And you know that Leon. He punched fuck you at Leon in the tunnel.
Did it?
You know that?
Yeah.
Mate, it was on Sky Sports. So we played Southampton, right? In the League Cup. And we got dicked. Like, they had Lallana, Lambert, De Pedro, Schneider, and they were a proper team. And Leon joined us late, so he was a bit unfitter than the rest of us. So Leon played well that night, but the sports scientists came on the pitch, and he's like, Leon, well done today, but tomorrow you have to run. Because that's what used to happen, mate. See, if they wanted you to get fit. You play a Tuesday, you run a Wednesday.
No.
And we Claudio's, I was like 5 yards for it, and Leon was like, fuck off, bruv. Get out my face, fuck off, bruv. And Di Canioooo can see like that they two are kind of arguing, so Di Canioooo comes on the pitch, mate, and like grabs him his shirt, and he's like, Leon, this is not the place we'll speak about, and Leon has went like that to him. Don't touch me, Leon's lost his head, mate, so we get down the tunnel, mate, and him and Di Canioooo just start going for it, eh? Di Canioooo was like a bull, mate.
Was he?
Honestly,
He's not got his five layers on, has he? He's not
five layers, he's sweating. Mate, I actually think it was a bit of a shit bag, because I probably should have helped Leon, but I was like, fuck that, mate. Straight in the dressing room. We were in the dressing room, like, peeking up, mate. Next thing, Leon just comes running past us, sprinting past the dressing room, because it's Swindon's dressing room. He's played there.
No, yeah. Never did.
You go down, the dressing room's there, but you can also go straight through at the gym and then back out onto the pitch. So, mate, see for like 5 minutes. Leon's passing us. He's back out on the pitch. Di Canioooo's passing us. They're just chasing each other for like 5 minutes. What's happening here?
So
Leon's obviously like fucked off into the car park, and Di Canioooo's came in, mate, and he's going mental. He's like, you tell your friend Leon, I fucking kill him if I ever get him. $6,000 a week he's on, lads. You boys are on shit money. I give him big money to come here, and this is how he treats me. Stuff's getting.
I like him a little bit more now. Exactly. Paulo's like top guy.
That's what I like about him, Philip.
So can you just not catch him? How did it
finish? He had a pair of slippy brogues on, mate. So it wouldn't surprise me if he's decked it a couple of times chasing Leon, mate, because his trousers were all grass stains, eh? So
I don't see Leon strapped 2 and strapped 6, Di Canioooo trying to catch him.
Early pacer. Was Leon giving as good as he got? Was he fighting back for a bit?
I think he was at first, mate, but then he realised that Di Canioooo... Mate, I've seen Di Canioooo hit the bag in the gym, eh? And he can go, man. He was obsessed with cage fighting. We went to Italy pre-season. Never forget it. First time with Di Canioooo. Turn up at this hotel, mate, and there's like 4 skinheads standing at the hotel waiting for him. And they're like, obviously, like Lazio casuals. And he hated me at this point, eh? So he's like, because I was overweight at first, and he's like, Simon, if I see you touch ice cream this trip, these 4 guys, they punch fuck out you. So we're like, I was like, wow. So one guy was a cage fighter. As we're waiting to get in the room, mate, Di Canioooo's sitting us on his laptop up, showing us this guy cage fighting in Italy. And he's like, yes, yes, look at him, pounding him, look. And we're like, what the fuck?
Oh, so this
was his mate who was standing there just like, and Di Canioooo was like commentating us through this guy, and this guy's thinking he's a dog's bollocks. So the next day, mate, we go out to training, it's like 90 degrees again, and this big guy comes out to training with us, he's like carrying the water, whips his top off, mate, and he's got like Di Canioooo's face tattooed on his back. This guy was like a Lazio fanatic, and Di Canio's like, he guards my house when I'm in Screwball. So that was like who you hung about with.
Did you have any ice cream, by the way?
Never fucking touched a drop, mate. Shut myself, but so I seen him hitting the bag in the gym a couple of times, mate, and he could proper go. Like, I wouldn't like it. I dig off.
He never told us that, Leon, did he, little fucking shitbag?
No, sorry, that was Leon. It was Leon Clark.
Oh, sorry, I thought it's Leon. He sounded out. But I can imagine.
He just had enough. Like, see what you said with Park, he just couldn't have taken it.
Yeah, but I've seen people try and get Clarky to do something after training. He's like, nah. So I can just imagine what he was like.
Yeah.
But I didn't know it kicked off in the tunnel.
It kicked off in the tunnel. Leon Knight came as well when Di Canio was there. Another character, mate. So Leon Knight comes into pre season, right? He's decent, by the way. See, Fivo's in that, like, getting a hold of it and setting it. Good player. But the running, mate, he was unfit. Eh? So we're doing, like, Di Canio's pre season is the hardest thing you've ever done. So we're doing laps. And Leon's like slowly falling back to where he's almost in a jogging pace, and Di Canio goes and runs with him. And we're like lapping him, and Leon's like, you busy cunts. So he's on trial, mate.
As if you're doing something wrong, like trying to get a fit.
You busy bastards, or somebody was shouting funny, mate. But then Di Canio's like, Leon, they're like running next season. Leon, you don't shout to the boys when they're running. You leave the boys, mate. And we're all running around, but looking at Leon and like Di Canio having a full blown argument, like jogging around the pitch, mate. So, like, Leon, the two Leons are the only two that have... Chrissy Martin used to stand up to him.
Did he?
Chrissy Martin used to give it that, oh, fuck.
Yeah, me. I can just imagine Chrissy.
Chrissy couldn't have taken it, eh? But then Di Canio would be like, Chrissy, you shut your mouth. 98 kilos. 98 kilos, this guy.
Fuck it, what had a good to be 98 kilos?
He is a heavy piece of kit as well, Chrissy.
Oh, Chris, mate, what a player as well.
Yeah.
Good lad, Chrissy.
So he went on loan from Norwich then?
He came on loan from Norwich,
aye.
But like Chrissy would miss a chance, and Di Canio would be on his knees, but Premier League, this guy, Premier League. But he expected like Chrissy just to be like Cristiano Ronaldo, eh? Every time he made a mistake, he would be on his knees, but this guy, because obviously he played in the Premier League. He's like, this is what the Premier League is now. No, he did stuff like that, mate. So I loved him, mate. He was a proper character.
To be fair, the Fodderingham thing must have pissed the lads off, surely. You know, were you, mate, there then?
Pissed off. We loved it, man. Pissed off about what? It was unbelievable to watch, eh? I was on the bench when we had a wee sub goalie next to us, Lee Bedwell, right? Never played a minute. No disrespect, lovely boy, but hopeless. Like, so Wes has had a beast against Stoke on the Tuesday night. We've managed to win 4-3, but I think Wes sold three of the goals. So Wes is, we've started the game against Preston, and Wes has started shaking, man. And Di Canio, he was turning into the goalie coach, and he's speaking in Italian to him. But Rafa De Vita played with us, mate. So Rafa was on the bench there, I was here, and Bedwell was there. I used to love when Rafa was on the bench, because obviously he'd tell you exactly what he was saying. And I goes like, to Rafa, what's he saying? He went, mate, he's hooking him. He's fucking going to hook him. It's like, mate, I looked up the clock, it was five minutes into the game. No. And I'm like, what? So then the next thing, the ball rolls back to Wes, and he kicks it to their player. He touches it, somebody else's score. And Di Canio turns around, mate, he had the most elasticated wrist you've ever seen. I don't know what he's been doing with his wrist, right? But he's like, you, Bedwell. And so we're walking, Bedders is shitting himself, mate, putting his boots in that on. He's up and down running. Next thing, mate, the board goes up. Wes is like cutting him off. Fuck you, walks off, kicks the bottle into the dressing room. Again, Di Canio to the goalie coach. Goalie coach goes running down. I says to Rafa, what's he said? He says, he told Wes he better go and get a train. But better get a train home, because if he's in that dressing room when I get in, I'm gonna kill him. So nothing else of it, mate, right? Wes hides, but then manages to get on the back of the bus. So I think Wes just goes straight on the back of the bus, but Di Canio doesn't know this. So after the game, he's gone off, he's not again, talking about Wes and all that sort of stuff. So we're sitting on the bus, mate, and Di Canio's out doing an interview, and he comes on the tellies. You know how the bus has got tellies? Six tellies on the bus. Driver puts Sky Sports News on. It's Di Canio. Wes is sitting up the back. So we're watching his interview. It was live. I think they'd done it live because they knew he was out raging. And he starts going, okay, this guy, League One Wes. League One Wes. We are not talking about Czech. We are not talking about De Gea. We are talking about Wes. League One Wes. Mate, and we're all looking at Wes, mate. And he is fuming, man. So when Di Canio gets back on the bus, he's like, look, Wes is like that on the bus, mate.
Aiden.
He doesn't want the can you think she's got a train home, mate? So Wes has went from Preston to Swindon. And we're all pissing ourselves laughing, man. Every time the car looks back, Wes is shiting himself. So Wes is up the back of the bus saying, nah, that's me done. Like, I'm not letting him speak to me and treat me like that. What, he's just mugged me off on the telly. He says, that's me done. So I think we get a text or something, or the next day, Wes doesn't come in, that's it. Di Canioooo's a meeting. He's like, lads, I tell you, if he doesn't come back and apologise, he's done. I guarantee you tomorrow he'll be in with a full-blown apology. So we go back, we're on the group chat saying, mate, he's the gaffer's saying you're going to apologise. I bet you shit yourself and apologise. Like, there's no way I'm apologising. I've spoke to my agents, so we're all winding it up. Next morning, sure enough, we're all sitting in a meeting. Wes comes in with the gaffer behind him. Wes starts speaking, the gaffer's behind him doing that. What did I tell you, lads? He shits his pants.
I like him now. Yeah, I like him. Yeah, I love him.
Like, you had a proper...
I love him.
But keep me in all year. Like, it wouldn't matter if you were the best player in the team or the youngest. He would treat everyone the exact same. And that's what I liked about him.
Yeah,
mate.
I don't mind that.
But it was, mate, every day was funny.
So he must have been shitting himself then for him to be hiding in the back of the bus. Because I don't... Imagine Alan Irvine doing that. You wouldn't hide, would you?
Mate, he was
thinking
scary.
You're going to get filled in.
No.
He was scary. Like, I've never really been scared of a manager, but the Canio, you're proper scared of him, eh?
What, physically scared of him? Like,
yeah, you could think he is going to punch fuck at me. Honestly, mate, you would,
especially if you see that with Clarkie. If you see him filling Clarkie and you're thinking, that could be me. Yeah.
Mate, seeing team meetings, right? He would start, like, do you ever do the clips after the games?
Yeah.
He would start, like, quite, okay. And then a clip with Wes would come up and he'd start banging the telly, mate. He would just switch quickly. How can we win this league with a fucking Sabutio goalkeeper? Stuff like that, mate. And then before you know it, right, it was like in an old classroom carpet. So it was like, if you slid on it, mate, you'd burn your, you'd cut your legs up, mate. See if a defender tackled wrong on that, mate, he'd be sliding about the carpet, eh? You'd be sitting watching it, trying not to laugh, mate. And he'd proper, like, my centre half, I want you to head it like this. Poof! And he'd like, fuck his head off the wall, man. How is he doing this, man? Mate, he had the hardest, he used to do this, he's like, what is this? And I would think, his head must be made of steel, mate, because he used to pure, mate, he'd hook himself on it, eh? It was a total show for like 2 hours. But how can you not like that, mate?
Yeah, apart from just a couple of days off a week, eh?
See, a couple of days off a week, yeah. It'd be good, man.
Good value.
The best bit's the flipping elasticated wrist. He'd
shove you over after 5 minutes. See if you thought you'd started maybe all right. He'd be at, you've got 5 more minutes and you're fucking off. I'd be at, what? And then before you know it, 10 minutes in, he'd catch. He was, mate, he'd always play with your head. 10 minutes in, you'd catch him again looking at me, but that. I'd be at. And then you go to walk home, he's like, I'd be at, what is he talking about, man? I was trying to watch the game, and then you weren't sure, but he was just always in your head, mate.
Did the players not shoot themselves on the pitch, like, about. Could they not relax?
Funniest thing ever, mate. We had Di Canioooo, and I think we were playing Notts County, it was Martin Allen. And it was me and John Spicer, right? I'll never forget this game. That day, Di Canioooo had it in it, shouted at me for the full 90 minutes. And Martin Allen was shouting to John Spicer for the foot. Mate, the two of us must have been the biggest nervous wrecks in a football game ever, right? We just kept passing it safe because he kept shouting at us. And Martin Allen's like, Spicer, we are fucking playing that way.
that's the worst one then. Fucking hell, suck yourself out, innit?
Oh, and the two of us just got abused for 90 minutes and we just looked at each other in a pure sympathetic way. But then seeing that, mate, like, there was never a time that you thought, I can't do that because you'll go mad. Like, you wanted to express yourself, mate, which I liked a bit. The only way he'd shout at you was if you weren't working hard enough.
Or you were hiding.
Or you were hiding, mate, he would shout at you for that, but...
So if you give the ball away, it wouldn't be one of them?
Nah.
Saying that, though, it sounds like... So he'd only threaten to bring you off if you were being lazy,
like,
or...
Yeah, like, mate, we used to work... This was League One, man. We used to work, like, for hours on defensive shape. And see, if you weren't doing that properly, you weren't in the right position when the ball was here, or that would send them crazy, man. That would send
them
crazy.
So he'd lose that in training as well?
Oh, my God, mate. Lose his melanin team. Like, he would do every demo, eh? So he would do a demo and he would, like, stanch it, mate. And then say we only had, like, a bag of 20 balls. Like, 20 balls would be in the trees after 5 minutes. And he would be, no! Stop! He'd go on his knees, mate. He'd be, Mamma mia, I come from Rome. 12-bedroom house. 6 million in the bank. Bentley to this shithole with this. You fucking assholes. Why can't you not do this? But funny in a way, do you know what I mean? Like, again, funny.
Can you see why it didn't work at Sunderland? You know, once he round some of the lads that have worked under Sir Alex and then he's sliding around on carpet.
But he was saying that it doesn't matter how big you were, he treated everybody the same. Yeah. It was them to the lads that got him sacked, wasn't it?
Like, they're on 40, we had to do it, mate, because we were all skint. Yeah. Do you know what I mean? If he fucks you off in League Two, then where are you going after that? You need to go to Aki on like 800 quid a week.
Yeah.
Were you there when Tommy done his hamstring?
And he's Tommy Miller, self-diagnostics, he kept shouting to him. Oh no, he was calling him Dr. Miller. Because Tommy had a dead leg or something, didn't he? And Tommy was saying, nah, gaffer, this isn't a dead leg. Like I've played like 20 years. I know when it's a dead leg. This is more serious. Like, oh, thank God, lads. We have a player who's also a doctor. So for like 6 months, he called him Dr. Miller. Eh? And Tommy's like the nicest guy in the world, man. Tommy was playing Brownie the weekend. And he's like, well done, Dr. Miller. Is everyone else okay? So that's why you liked him as well.
I like him, though.
His patter was fucking top notch. Really good, man. But then he hated night suit. Sunday the boys would come and hang in, mate, and he would proper make a point of coming up, standing there, trying to smell your breath. Mate, one time I had to come off against Crawley because I shit myself. I wasn't feeling well that day, and I fucking farted and felt. I was like, gaffer, I need to come off, I'm done here. He's like, right, get yourself up the road. He's like, promise me, you don't go out tonight. And I was like, nah, fuck, course not. I'm like, hang in here, man. So I went up the road that night, and I was renting a flat off Michael Timlin. So it was like an open plan flat, so your bedroom and living room were kind of next to each other. So my missus was then, the X Factor was on. She was blowing drying her hair, so I turned it up to like fucking 40 so I could hear it. Next thing, my phone rings. And he's assistant manager. He's like, Simon, where are you? And I was like, in my house. And he said, and I could hear the canyon whispering. I asked him, can we phone his house? Can we phone your house phone? Can I phone your house phone? And I was like, I've not got a house phone, I've only got a mobile. Okay, we're coming up. And I was like, no, you can't come up, but my missus is bollock naked doing her hair and I'm sitting watching her, I'm not feeling well. And he's like, where are you? And I could hear him in the back, where are you? And I was like, I'm in the house, man. What? He's like, you're out, I can tell you're out. And I was like, gaffer, I'm not, I'm sitting in the house. He's like, okay, you don't come in tomorrow. So I hung the phone up, mate, and never thought anything else. Next day, Paul Caddis phones me. He's like, mate, every player got interrogated for an hour asking who was out with Simon Ferry last night. Proper.
Because you've got the music on, like.
Because I had the music on. Proper para about people. Yeah. Mate, you'd be standing in a bar, right? No word of a lie, you'd be standing with a pint pure enjoying yourself, and you would just see him, like, go by the window, and he'd be like, oh. he'd be looking in the window, mate, and you'd be, like, hiding. It was crazy. But he knew everything.
Did he have a face-to-face after X Factor get?
Nah, I think he maybe did. I always used to have face-to-face with him while he was getting changed, mate. So it would end up, sometimes he'd be in his pants talking to you. And like then it would go on to like what you were doing wrong in the game and he would be running about in his pants showing you what you were doing wrong. And that's why I liked him, mate. But you know the one about the time we went out? Have you heard the one when we went out on a Saturday? We could get promoted on the Tuesday. Oh, fuck. This is where he's flipped. This is the worst I've seen him, mate. So we were, we played Plymouth. His mum died. In Italy, on a Thursday. So he went away back to Italy. Assistant took training. Came back for the game Saturday. He says, okay, lads, we're nearly there. Win today, win Tuesday, we're promoted. He says, but I have to go back to Italy after Saturday to arrange my mum's funeral. Go out, play, beat Plymouth. He comes in after the game. He's like, lads, brilliant, nearly there. He says, please, lads, please, I beg you. Please, Simon. Two others. He's like, you three, please do not go out tonight. Please, we have a massive game Tuesday. We've worked hard all year. Get this done and we're up. And then you can party. Mate, he's not even shut the door. I'm like, where are we going, man? Fucking older shot away. Piss it, man. We'll beat them. We'll beat them easy. Where are we going, mate? My last memory is fucking jumping about a nightclub in Swindon at like 3 a.m. Eh? So, go to training on Monday. Nothing else is said because obviously the assistant's taking it. He was quite quiet. Tuesday, we turn up to leave the county ground at like 4:30. And we're all sitting in the meeting. And he comes walking in, and he looked raging, but he always looked raging, mate. And then he kind of told a couple of jokes, got raging again, and then named the team. So there was 5 of us out that night, right? 3 of us were starting, 3 of them were starting, 2 of us were on the bench. I was on the bench. So my mate was next to me who I was out with, and I was like, fuck, he knows, man. He knows we've been out. And he's like, how does he know we've been out? The other 3 are starting.
Were you expecting to play?
I was expecting to play. Yeah. So we get on the bus and the 5 of us up the back of the bus and he would like look up the back and we'd be like, fuck, he knows, man. And then he would laugh and joke with his sister. He's like, nah, he doesn't know. So we're meant to be preparing for this game, yeah, to go up against Aldershot. I'm on the bench, right? And the boys are getting beat 1-0, of course. It's going to happen, wasn't it? So he's like, that to me, go and warm up. So as I'm warming up, he knows, man, definitely. And then I come back and he makes a joke while I'm getting changed. So my mate who was on the bench, I was, mate, he doesn't know, man. He just made a joke with me, I'm fine. Just as I go, before I go on, I can't remember what he whispered in my ear, mate, but he said something that made me know that he knew. So it was like 20 minutes to go, we are one down. See, when I run on the pitch, mate, I'm not giving a fuck about the game. I'm like to the other three that were out. He knows, lads.
He's got us.
We are fucked here. We need to score or we are done. Of course, mate, they go right up the pitch. As soon as I come on, what's the chance? I think I might be slipped or something. Eh? Gave the ball away. They run up and score. Aldershot, 2-0, beat us. I remember us four walking back off. It was the slowest walk, mate. I think the fans left before we got in. That was how slow they walked off the pitch. Shite in our cell, mate. We get in, sit down. Mate, he fucking erupts. He's got like a Rolex, mate. It's a belter. It might even be a Hublot. It's a belter I watch. And do you know what I was saying about how hard these fists are, mate? At Aldershot, it's like metal walls, mate. It's like old school wooden, well, whatever it's called, brick walls. Hey, man. Rolex pops off. That's how hard he hit it. He never even went like that. Bang. Smacked it, right?
As
soon as he comes in, mate. We are sitting. There's the metal skips. Boof! And nearly hits Alan Connell. Alan Connell has to move. iPod, mate, right? On the stand. Boots it. Off the wall, smashes the iPod. Gets right in my face. You're the shittest professional I've ever met. I knew at the start, because at pre-season he hated me. I knew it, I should have trusted my gut. You're the worst professional. And I'm like that. And then, who's
you're expecting
it?
One.
I was expecting one, mate. Yeah. I thought that time he would, mate. And he's just going berserk, right? And then this was the thing about him, because you were so scared. And then he would do something that you would want to piss yourself laughing, right? So I'm like that, and he's going mental, man. He's like, I'm going to go out to the papers, the radio, I'm going to slaughter you. It's your fault we're not going to go up this year. He's the worst professional ever. And I think he just goes like, and then we're all like that, and then he goes, Fabrizio! No, that's what he goes. He goes, you think you're the big man? You're out in Swindon with the music that you like to dance. And mate, you're so scared, but you're also trying not to laugh. And then he went, you like to drink the poison? Drinking the poison, right? And he went, you like to dance? You like to dance in your face? And then he turns to his assistant manager and he goes, Fabrizio, put the music on. Let them dance. But he had that much control over his assistant manager. And us, mate, the assistant manager wasn't sure whether to actually put the music on. Or so he was like that with iPod. And we weren't sure whether we should get up and dance. But then the next day, mate, and he was on the week again on the bus. We could hear him on the radio. And names us. I want every fan to know Simon Ferry, Alan McCormick. Who else was it? Luke Rooney. Somebody like the usual suspects. Again, I've let this club down. Front page of the paper the next day, mate.
Then, just get
but that was a good thing about him, mate. So he slaughtered us, right? And then the next day, he took me into his office and was like, Simon, why do you want to do this to your life and your career? This is why you play in League Two. You're a good player. He's proper sound, mate. But after that, I thought he was going to fucking kill us. Proper sound. And then the next day, he was like brand new. He's like, right, forgotten about a week's wages, I think it was. And he says, right, we'll go to Gillingham and win.
Did you go that year?
No, I got beat. But then that was that. He found out that Wes and somebody else had been out. Because after the game, he went, who was it? And we all put our hands up. And the two boys that hadn't been caught, see the three that started? One of them put their hand up. The other two never. So that's what I'm saying about every day happening. So they two think they've got up. And I don't know how he's found out, mate. 2 days later, before Gillingham, he finds out that they two had been out as well. So Wes, the goalie, and I can't remember who else it was. It was one of our better players, mate. Just never played them, man. Did we got beat for Gillingham, but Shrewsbury got beat, which meant we got up. Mate.
Oh, so you went up.
So we're all buzzing after the Gillingham game, mate, and he's patching us, eh? Still patching us. Because of obviously what we'd done to him the week before. But, mate, honestly, I couldn't speak highly enough of him. I loved him. I loved playing for him. I did.
Fucking hell.
Change mate, your mind? Every day, like...
Change your mind?
Not enough. Not enough for 78 days in straight. Not enough.
But see the days, mate, we would still go out all the time, eh? Like, I've never been out as much. But you just hide it. So one Christmas day, he hated Christmas days. So he's like, you don't get
a Christmas. Were you not a wine drinker? Or
yeah, that was the thing, mate. You weren't allowed butter or ice in your drink, but you were allowed a glass of wine at night. Which baffled me, eh? But Tommy Miller told you about the time he came out in Italy, didn't he?
Down the stairs.
Oh, mate. It's like Brad Pitt walking in, eh? With the shades on. The Swindon gear. But Tommy missed out. I'm sure he ended up rolling about with people like that. Guys in the nightclub, we're all sitting, mate, and the next thing you know, there's like a big rab on, look, and the gaffer's rolling about with somebody, and we all went over to help him, and the next day he's like, "Yous will be you're my friends for life, the way you backed me up last night." I didn't even think I helped, mate, I just pretending that I was helping him, but he's like, "Yous will be my friends for life."
That entrance, was it music off?
Music off, mate. Lights spotlight.
Off.
Spotlight on Di Canioooo walking down the stairs in the nightclub. He's like, ah, winking at you in that. I think you had shades on in a nightclub, mate. So what have you got shades on for, isn't it?
It's like Take Me Out, isn't it? The best Take Me Out ever.
But you like him, don't you? Yeah. He would sit you down, mate, and tell you stories and that. Like, brilliant, man. Really good, honestly. I think you'd like him, eh?
Yeah.
We played some great football as well, mate. I see when you're winning every week, it makes a difference.
Yeah.
We see when he left. We on the diet, mate. We played, Tommy was there as well. I can't believe he never told us. So we played like dog shit FC in pre-season, right? Like a local team. And, obviously, you weren't allowed ice or butter or stuff like that.
Why not ice?
Fuck knows, mate. Honestly, who knows?
Butter, I can half get butter, but ice?
Ice in your drink, I know. Strange, isn't it? But anyway, we played this team. I think we won like 8-0, but he was raging after the game, mate. Like, all your body language was shit in that game. He's like, beat it. They've put food on for you. Go and get some food. I'm going to stay in here. And he was raging, eh? So we went through to the canteen, mate. And just like a local place, it's like sausages and chips. So we're all standing, we're like, should we eat this? And some of the boys are like, nah, he'll fuck, man. And other boys are like, well, he said go and eat food, that's what they put on, fucking eating it. So all the boys, mate, have filled up. I must have had about 10 sausages on my plate. I hadn't ate proper food for like 2 months since he's been in. Hundreds of chips, ketchup, mayonnaise. Mate, I'll never forget his face when he came in. No! What is this? What is this? And he's pure screaming at the wee canteen lady. He's like, who told you to make this for my players? So he's like, everyone on the bus. Comes on the bus, mate. We've all got like ketchup and that.
Just pick a couple of sausages up in your pocket.
He's like, who likes the sausage? Who likes the sausage, mate? So you're trying not to laugh. Who eats the sausage? Put your hand up if you eat the sausage. Nobody's it, but we're all sitting there, so we all put their hand up. And the next day, mate, we come in and he's, mate, we had a meeting for an hour and a half on what goes into a sausage, English sausage. We had a big meeting about, I like English sausage, sausage, but you, professional athlete, English sausage? Like going nuts, mate. And then he's like that, ketchup, I can understand ketchup, but mayonnaise, I wouldn't feed it to the flies. I'm gone, mate. He used to say to me all the time, Simon, please don't laugh, this is serious. I couldn't just not laugh at him, mate. It was so funny. And that was a shot of shit, mate. I remember we had a meeting for like 40 minutes on how you wash your hands. 40 minutes, mate. You're like, when the fuck's training starting? He's like, lads, I watched something with an Olympic athlete last night, how he washes his hands. And he talked us through the full documentary, mate. And it's like, Baltic, mate, on a December in Swindon, fucking freezing. We're standing, learning how to wash your hands. Bit brilliant. Honestly, really good.
Are you a Celtic fan?
Celtic fan.
So you were obviously buzzed off watching him when he played up there.
But he used to say that. He went, okay, lad, you know, I had a very fucking top career. Top Milan, Juventus, West Ham, top career. Okay, I had 1 year in Scotland. Fucking care, was that? Celtic are a better club than West Ham, you dick. but he says Tommy Burns, who was my youth team coach, that was his manager. They were quite similar, mate. He used to say that. One year in the Scottish League, but the rest at the top. They signed some terrible players, mate. See, at first, they were just signing anyone, eh? So Paul Caddis was the captain at the time. He was my best mate. And he's like, mate, the gaffer pulled him and he says, we signed Risa, big signing, he'll play centre midfield, he'll get on it, and he was zinging it about. So Caddis came to me, he's like, because I wasn't playing at the time, he hated me at this time, I was like the fourth choice centre midfielder, he told me. He's like, mate, you're fucked, we're signing John and Risa tomorrow to play centre mid. And I was like, I'm fucked. Next day, mate, this Namibian guy turns up, Oliver Risa. Hopeless. Hopeless, mate. Honestly, like. So, mate, this is the best story ever, right? I eventually get back in the team, and it's me and him centre mid. Di Canioooo used to love unopposed shape, right? So you would just, one team would be set up in 11, another team would be set up 11. You'd start from the back, you'd run up, score, and then they would dip. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So just like phase the play. So this Namibian guy's, ball goes to right back, he was busy as any, mate. He goes sprinting across, like checking his shoulder a million times to impress Di Canioooo. And the ball gets rolled to him, right? So remember, it's unopposed shape, and he just boots it out the pitch. Di Canioooo's like, no! Oliver! What is this? And the boy turns to me and goes, hey, maybe there, lad, you can tell me that I have time to turn, huh? And I was like, dickhead, it's unopposed shape. Of course you've got time to turn. There's nobody marking you. So Di Canioooo's on him, right? This session, and he absolutely folds, right? Next time he goes to get it off the left centre back, he's trying to like impress Di Canioooo again. Takes it off the left centre back. Di Canioooo used to just walk about the pitch as like a referee or whatever. Turns to take the ball, and Di Canioooo turns to walk that way. And mate, he goes to zing it to the right winger, and he has curly toed it. The curly toe of death, mate. But with pace on it. So it's absolutely went, shh, mate. He turns, man, and I, honestly, I thought he's going to punch his cunt in here. And I think he says to him, Ollie, okay, we are done. Everyone get in. Had enough, mate, and just sent us on to go and get a shower and get up the road. Brilliant, mate. That's what I say every day, mate. It was something, eh?
So Di Canioooo was obviously watching where the ball should be going, and it's just fucking...
And it's just caught him in the back of the nut, mate.
You were some thought, I'm all right here, actually.
Mate, that was him, because when I fell out with him, see, at first he hated me because I was overweight. I think I stepped on the scales and, like, chewed wrappers fell out my pocket. And he was like, you won't play for me in this state. You can't represent me when you look like this. Then I got myself back fit and then went to play Burnley, mate. This is how much you used to play with your head, though. So I'm back in his good plans. I think we're getting on. He loved, like, clothes and stuff, music, similar stuff, so we got on quite well with that. We're playing Burnley, mate, right? Like, the game before the start of the season, I'm sitting on the bench. Mate, and I look around and, like, it's me and two young lads that are left with 10 minutes to go. And I'm thinking, what the fuck, man? So he's like, to the two young lads, you two go and warm up. You're going on. And I'm looking at him and he's just staring at me. And I'm like, what the fuck? So like a minute to go, mate, he's like, to me, go on. And I was like, nah. Fuck that. You're like mugging us off here, eh? So I think he like dragged us on, mate, and I had to go on. And after the game in the dressing room, he has cracked. Like he's like to me, it'll take a miracle for you to play for me. Fourth, maybe even fifth choice centre midfield player. Fifth choice, you won't play for me again. So I phoned my agent, I was like, get out. He's like, nobody will take you, man, you're fucked, you need to stay. So first 5 games, mate, I never played a game, eh? Sat on the side the full 5 games. We played dagging him away. Cads came up to me on the bus again, he went, mate, the gaffer was going to play the night. But because it's dagging him away, it's going to be a bit physical. He's going to go with the two lads and maybe bring you on for the last 30 minutes. So again, mate, he's like, he likes you again. You're back in his plans. Mate, doesn't put us on, eh? So I'm like, on the bus back to the Cads. Nah, he's fucking with me. He's went and told you that to come and tell me just to play with my head. But then the next game, he pulls me in his office and he's like, okay, fat boy, tomorrow you start. He went, it's up to you now. Can you prove me wrong? And I was like, yeah, of course I can. So then after that, I think I played the most minutes of everyone else that season. And then on the...
You rise to the challenge,
mate, and he buzzed off at eh? And then the last, won the league that year, he phoned me the next week and he's like, for the whole time I'm at Swindon, you'll be here, no matter what. He says, you're the fucking type that I need. But you went up against it, you proved me wrong. Oh, mate, massively. Improved his, mate, he's a great coach. Yeah.
You must be fit as well.
Fit as fuck, mate, honestly. Fit as fuck. Mate, we used to beat, like, we beat Wigan in the FA Cup, beat Leicester, Burnley. We beat loads of teams there through Di Canioooo's coaching. Like, how well set up in that moment. He was fucking top coach, like.
I'm not having a bad word said about him from now on.
Mate, honestly.
Paulo Di Canioooo. Paulo Di Canioooo.
See, before the game, mate, you used to
get a spotlight when I go down them stairs.
Every podcast, mate, you should get a spotlight on you. But see, before games, mate, you used to get so nervous, eh? I used to watch him. I was obsessed with him, eh? See, in the mirror, he'd look in the mirror like that to himself. That least time. See every time before you went to go at me, he'd come and grab you and he'd be like, you're gonna be fucking brilliant for me today. In your face, and he would slap you. See in the tunnel, you were like, ah, fucking get out here, man. And see when you came back in after a good game, he'd be like, yes! It was proper like
proper meant it.
Proper meant it, mate. And he'd like say things to you and think, fuck me, man, that he's a hero. That's why I liked him, mate.
Yeah.
If you were an owner of a club, would you give him the job?
I would, mate, because I know he'd put everything into making it better. I would, like, if I got a lower league club, I would give him a job.
Yeah.
Definitely, mate.
Did he go anywhere after Sunderland? Has he had a job since?
I don't think he has, mate, nah.
We'll get him another job, lads.
Get him a job, mate. Yeah, you'll get him another
from top to bottom, innit?
Well, mate, Richie Wellens has just went to...
Salford.
So, I think he's like 10-1 for the Swindon job, mate.
Let's get a petition going, man.
Yeah.
Get him back.
But I bet the lads were at Swindon, like, no, please, no.
Did he, going back to the keeper, did he fuck Wes off that? League One Wes.
No, that's what I mean. Like he wouldn't fuck him off, eh? So he would cane him and slaughter him, and he's like, right, you've apologised, you're back in. But we had a goalie, mate, that made a mistake. A young Italian kid he brought over. He made a couple of mistakes in a row. That's why he brought Wes in. And that keeper ran round the pitch for a year, mate. You put his gloves on for a year, he just ran round the pitch. We used to be training, mate, and I'll just see this wee 21-year-old just jogging about, mate, for a full year, just never played him. Never. Oh, I didn't get his old to train.
I don't mind him.
Yeah,
I don't mind Paulo.
We said well there, considering we said we'll come on to Paulo.
We'll speak about it later.
He's a big name, isn't he? You need to talk about him, man.
We'll have to go back to Swindon for Billy anyway, won't we?
We will,
Billy Painter?
Yeah.
What a guy. So I went down to Swindon, was my first full time team. Danny Wilson, who you know, is a hero, man. What a guy. Love him. He was one of them as well, mate. Like every Saturday, but lads, win, lose, or draw, go and get a pint. Make sure he's all go out and get a pint together.
Old school.
You used to sit and tell you Brian Clough stories, mate. I loved that, eh?
Yeah.
After the game. But then, so Billy, my first weekend, Billy, he was the top man in the place, Billy. Everyone like looked up to him. He's a funny guy. He was on fire
at
you.
He was on fire then.
He was, mate. Uh-huh. And he phoned me on a Thursday night. I'd came, obviously, for reserve football. He's like, all right, lad, we're going to go to a quiz at the Torre Hill tonight. He says, it'll just be a couple of pints, then we'll be up the road. Mate, I remember sitting there at like 2:30. I wasn't, obviously, came for reserves. This is my first team debut on the Saturday, mate. It's a Thursday night. He's got me out to 2:30, mate. I remember waking up on the Friday, fucking rough. Played my debut on the Saturday, done well, got man of the match. And he's like, right, if you've got man of the match on a Saturday, that's us every Thursday now, isn't it? So we were out 2 or 3 times a week, that team, mate. So the guy I ended up staying with was a guy from Scotland, Scott Cuthbert. Scotty wasn't a big drinker, like he was a proper pro, wanted to do well. And I was in with that other crowd who didn't give a fuck and would just go out all the time. So we were out one night and Billy's like, where's Scotty? And I was like, he's not coming out, he's staying in the house. He's like, tell you what, lad, have you got a spare key for that house? And I went, he's gave us a key, he went, give me it, I'm gonna get it cut. I'm gonna terrorise him. So Billy takes the key off me, goes and gets it cut, gets a key. Every day at training, right, Billy would like shoot off early. Everybody, where the fuck's Billy going? Billy would go into our house, unlock the door, and he would start off with just like pouring the milk out and putting it back in the fridge. So me and Scotty would come home, Scotty would open the door, come in, he'd go to make, he loved a cup of tea after training, go to make a cup of tea, and he's like, what the fuck's the milk? He's like, I'm sure there was milk in here this morning. He would get back in his motor, and he'd be driving as that, I'd be killing myself laughing. Remember, one day we came home, Scotty had an ensuite up in his room, goes up to it, and he's like, oh, what the fuck? Billy had done a shit in his ensuite and left it. It's fucking stinking. So Billy's just terrorising him every day, mate, and it finished it. Billy had a wife and a kid, 2 kids, mate. We went back to Glasgow for the weekend, and Billy's texting me on the Sunday, have you landed yet, lad? Have you landed? It's like 28-year-old, mate, with a wife and 2 kids, eh? And I was like, that's just landed at Bristol. We'll be in an hour and a half. He's like, okay, lad, I'm in your house with 2 of my mates with balaclavas and knives. Mate, never forget. Scotty opens the door into the living room. Billy jumps out with a balaclava and and Scotty fucking shits himself.
Mate, I think understandably.
We'll give you that, Scott.
I think I would as well.
And big Scotty punched a hole in the wall. He was that raging, mate. He was so fuming. Billy's like, I've been terrorising you for months, lad.
So when he took his mask off?
Took his mask off, and they were nearly rolling about, eh? Big Scotty was raging. And that just summed Bill up, mate. 2 wife and 2 kids, and that was what his main priority in life was. But what
yeah, that's incredible.
It's brilliant, mate, isn't it? And he told you the one about Cheltenham, didn't he?
Were you there?
I was there, mate, of course. We played Southampton the night before, right? Charlie Austin scored, beat them 1-0. That secured us in the playoffs. So we could have lost every game further on in.
Yeah.
And we'd still be in the playoffs. So the chairman was, I think he owned Bet365 or Betfred or something, Jeremy Ray. Came in after the game, he's like, amazing, lads. We were tipped to go doing that, yeah. I've got you a box on the finishing line at Cheltenham tomorrow. Fucking all expense, food, drink, whatever you like. So again, Billy was like the lead guy. He's like, lads, 10 o'clock in the boozer. Or 10 o'clock in Billy's house, maybe. So we get there at 10. We're fucking steaming, man. Steaming. We go up to the box at Cheltenham. Like, dog and duck, mate. We look like dog and duck, man. I had to get a shot of Michael Timlin's suit. I didn't own a suit, mate. So Michael Timlin was smart, mate. He gave us an Armani pinstripe suit. I think I ended up pouring a pint over my head with his suit on. He was fucking fuming. And that's what happened. So I had a shocker that day, mate. Every race lost. Last race, it was either me and Danny Ward or me and Stephen Darby. I think it was maybe Darbs. I was like, I've had a fucking shocker. He says, I'm sticking 20 quid on the 45-1 outsider. Mate, came in. So what's that? What did I win? 900 quid?
You'd won a few quid, aye.
900 quid. So Billy's like to me, £500 of that and I'll run the last length naked. Cheltenham, we were like, ah, fuck off. Mate, bear in mind, I think Billy maybe knew he was getting a move to Leeds at this point. So the last thing you'd want to be doing, mate, is getting lifted for running ball naked the last length of Cheltenham.
Photo finish.
He's like, I'll tell you what. He says, £50 ahead and I'll do it. So we've all chipped in £50. He's in the box. He's like, to one of the young lads, oh, you, come on, down with me. So we're all at the box, mate, every one of us packed
in. People, is the crowd still in?
Mate, dribs and drabs.
Yeah.
People are just leaving. So we kind of see him for ages, man. We kind of see him for ages. We're like, he's not fucking doing it. Next thing, mate, Bill just appears up the side. But he's like, he's crawling up the side, naked. Up to get up to the top. But he doesn't want to start at the finish, you know what I mean? He comes at the finish and he's crawling and we're in tears, mate. But stewards are like, none of, and he's crawling bollock, mate. Up. I don't even have pants on maybe at that time. Pants on to crawl up. Next thing, mate, he just appears and he's like that. And we're all going fucking mental at the back, banging the box, mate. Next thing, he just hears it down the last night of the Cheltenham. Mate, I think he'd over the last fence. Rolled up, finishing line, into the bogs. I think Stewart's maybe caught me at the last minute, but he got into the bogs, suited and booted, back up to the box, and mate, hero. I think he made like a grand.
Never got away with it.
Got away with it, mate. Went out to Cheltenham that night. What a night it was.
Yeah, it's good.
See that Swindon team for me.
Really, it was with
brilliant,
it.
Honestly. Just out constantly. Like, Sean Morrison was there, I've told you about. Billy and Sean together were a bad combo, man. So Billy was the main man. Sean was the young lad that was daring that he was told.
Oh, just try and impress, like.
Just to try. Everyone wanted to impress Bill. Everyone wanted to impress
Sir Bill.
Sir Bill.
Sir Bill, mate. Like, we'd be on night suit, right? And Sean's like 6'5". Young kid, never played a game, and Billy but that. Going bomb through that table. And Sean would run, mate, and jump, and just... And a table in a pub would just collapse, mate. And Sean would be like that. And Billy was like, pour that pint over your head. So he just bombed through a table like that. Pouring a pint over it. Billy would just get... And then one, I remember one time Billy's at that going 2 foot that bouncer. Never forget it, mate. So the bouncer's got his back to us. He can't see us. He's obviously dealing with people at the front door. And big Sean just goes up and bang! 2 foot something, mate. But Billy had that much pull at Swindon. Like, see if a bouncer say something to Sean, Billy would be like, what is that, lad? And they would just leave him, eh? Mate, he was like the king of Swindon, man.
Fucking why did he? I don't know why he ever left, Bill.
I know.
Fuck scary. Leeds.
Sir Bill.
But that playoff final, that playoff final, we got beat. And the next day we had a do for... Because they thought we were going to go up, obviously. So they arranged a big do the next day at the county ground. For us... And it was like directors, fans that had paid a lot of money to be there. Like the important people in Swindon, like I think the mayor and all that was fucking there. So again, we're meeting there at 4 or something. We meet at 12. Steaming again, walked in, and I'm standing in the toilet doing a piss, and Bill comes in next to me, and we're getting a laugh, and he just goes like that, and starts pissing all over me, mate. I'm steaming, I'm like, mate, what are you doing, man? So I start pissing on him. At that minute, the one person you wouldn't want to walk in at that minute is Sean Morrison. I think he just gets bollock, mate, and starts pissing everywhere. He's pissing all over all the walls, and we're like, fuck it, I think it was in my face. And so Billy runs out, comes back in with a fire extinguisher. And Billy's like, shh, me and Sean, and we are covered, mate, in foam. Sean's in his pants at this point. 19-year-old kid, mate, never played a minute. So I think Sean starts wrestling with me, and Billy starts wrestling with me. And the three of us, like, stagger out at the main bit where everyone's standing. And Bill starts fire extinguishing the bar. Like, the bar's here, and then there's a slidey bit underneath the bar. He starts stinging it, and he's like, Sean, Clinsman Sean. Big Sean, mate, 6'5". Everyone, mate, I remember looking at people's faces and they're in disbelief. And Sean, full mate.
Club officials,
all sorts. Sean's Clinsman it down the side of the bar. Starts bombing it, spinning himself around. I think his balls maybe came out his pants. And Danny Wilson, who I hadn't seen angry a lot, went up to him. And he's like, get yourself up the fucking road. Get yourself up the road. And Bill's just laughing like that.
But never said like, out to Bill.
Never said out to Bill.
Big Swindon.
Sean was... That was an eventful day, mate. I thought that would have killed my move, but he ended up giving me a 4-year deal, so fucking worked out fine for me.
The thing is, he's got beat as well. It's all right. If you go up, you're kind of like, oh, fuck that.
Yeah. Exactly. But that's why we done so well that year. Like, we were one of the better teams in the league.
Did Danny understand that, though? With his old school mentality?
Danny loved it, mate. Mm. See, I used to prank phone call people. So we had this young kid, Callum Kennedy, who we played with Wimbledon and stuff like that, left back. I don't know if you ever came across him. But Cal loved himself. Like, he was a good looking kid, good left foot. And he was playing for the reserves this day. So all the first team were in the dressing room after training. The reserves had just finished. We'd heard they'd beat Reading 3-0. So I went out to the boys. Somebody texted me saying, no, Callum texted me. Sorry, saying, Geese was on fire today. He says, my agent told me that there was scouts here as well watching. He says, I'm buzzing, absolutely buzzing. So we were on the dressing room. I was like, oh, Cal's just texted me. And I think Bill was like, mate, prank him. So I put Cal's number in. As I'm doing this, mate, Danny's walked in the dressing room. So Danny's like, what's up? What you doing? And I was like, I'm going to prank you, Cal. He's like, yeah, go for it. This is the gaffer, eh? So I've pranked Cal, sitting.
And I was like, hi, Callum, how are you doing? It's John Gregg here from Ipswich. Me and Roy, I don't know if you noticed, but me and Roy were at your game today. And he's like, yeah, geez, yeah.
Geez.
And I was like, you were absolutely outstanding, weren't you? And he's like, yeah, I was, wasn't I? He says, yeah, I thought he meant, yeah, I done all right, didn't I? And I was like, he's like, yeah, Roy, we're looking for a left back. He says, would you be interested? He's like, yeah, of course I would. Your gaffer's standing there. He's like, yeah, I'm not really playing at Swindon. I think I deserve to be playing and I'm not really getting a look in. So the gaffer's like to me, keep him going. So I was like, so if the opportunity came up tomorrow to leave Swindon and go to Ipswich, would you do it? He's like, yeah, geez, of course. It's like massive club, innit? And he's like, to play under a legend like Roy Keane. So the boys are like to me, right, just say something like outrageous here. And I was like, right, that's fine. He's fine. That's fine. He says, the gaffer thinks you're a wee bit too pretty. He says he wants the team to be horrible. He says, we say to him, would you be willing to shave your head? We want teams to fear us next year. So would you be willing to shave your head and to come and play for Roy Keane? He's like, 30 second pause. He's like, fuck it, yeah, geez, I'll shave it. I'll shave it. And then we were like, I've noticed that your throws aren't long. If our full backs are going to play, they need to have long throws. He's like, I'll batter the gym, geez. I'll batter the gym from now to summer. And Danny Wilson just comes on the phone, he went, Callum, I'll see you in my office tomorrow morning. He's like, oh, fuck. But then Danny was brand new on me, eh? Like, the next day he understood, had a laugh about it. Danny Wilson as well, mate, right? We were playing Brighton on Saturday. That was it, we were playing Brighton on Saturday. We were struggling at this point, mate, right? Struggling big time. This was the season we got relegated. And me, Alan O'Brien and Scott Cuthbert went to get a tattoo in Cheltenham. Well, they two did, I wasn't going to get one. But I went at the time and I was like, fuck it, I'm going to get one. I got Shit Happens tattooed on my arse. So I was like to the boys, didn't I tell the gaffer, please? We're having a nightmare and I've just had Shit Happens tattooed on my arse. So obviously the boys tell Danny. So we're playing on Saturday, like, and on the Friday we come in and he's like, different with me. And I'm like, oh, fuck, what's happening here, man?
What does he know?
We spent an hour playing bare arse with me on the goal line. He found out and he wasn't bothered. He's like, right, get your arse on the goal line. Instead of doing shape or like preparing for Brighton, the boys hit balls off my arse for an hour before the game. He's like, right, get yourselves in, we've got to beat the next day.
Who told him?
Oh, I don't know. Probably would have been Bill. No, Bill left
Sir
that
Bill.
Year.
Sir Bill.
Bill left that year, so I don't know who they told him. Maybe Charlie Austin or something like that. Uh-huh.
Seemed like you were alright for a bit of crack, didn't it?
Oh, yeah. Danny Wilson's a hero, mate. Honestly, really good guy. Proper up for a laugh, eh?
He hasn't really featured, has he?
No.
I know you know him, but...
Yeah. I don't think he has.
Did you like him?
Lovely guy. I didn't really know him as a manager. Right. Didn't know him from after football, really. Right. Played a bit of golf with him and that.
Oh, did you?
Yeah.
He was brilliant, mate. I loved him, eh?
Yeah.
Proper old school, like, but... Just tell you, mate, if you were shit, you were shit, and if you were good, you were good. Yeah, that was it.
Bit of honesty.
You don't mind that, though, do you?
No, that's what you want, mate.
What I mean?
Yeah.
I hate that. See, when a manager doesn't tell you, and then you know he's whispering about you behind your back, I can't go that.
Yeah.
That's what I loved about the Canio, mate. Every week you knew where you stood with him, eh? You knew whether he thought you were good or you thought you were shit, and I love that.
We're back to the start. Should we start?
We've done it in reverse.
Right, that's the Swindon podcast finished.